give thanks and praise for life, you know, Selassie is alive. Yeah, man, the land of the priests.
Green Castle Hill, the Stonehenge of the Caribbean.
2018, Winter Solstice Experience. Join us in Sun City, Antigua, from Tuesday the 18th to Monday the 24th day of December. Come and bask in the mystic of the Stonehenge of the Caribbean. Come and experience sun, sea, sand, and legend. Spend 7 days and nights in the heart of the Caribbean. Visit our national heritage sites. Meet and greet our people. Sample the local fruits and produce. Plus, the beach, banquets, lectures, yoga, and of course, Green Castle Hill. Green Castle Hill, Mount Anna.
Save our national treasure.
Alafia to each and everyone. Salamta and blessed love. Honorable Priest Isaac here. It is with great joy that I am happy to announce to you that I have officially released my first ebook, Anu Ancient and Modern Revisited. This is the continuation process of our easy-to-read books. Within the pages of Anu Ancient and Modern Revisited, we take the time to show you the spiritual connection with the island of Antigua and Heliopolis in Kemet in Egypt, with the island of Antigua and the legendary continent of Atlantis. We also highlight Green Castle Hill, also known as Mount Anu, which is known as the Stonehenge of the Caribbean, with the countless of megaliths that align with the movements of the heavens. This is a must read for all those who are students of the esoteric realms, astronomy, geology, and ancient sites. Of course, to get a copy of your book, all you have to do is to contact us at area code 1268-728-3162, call, text, or even WhatsApp. Or you can email us at priestisaac27@gmail.com to get a copy of your ebook, Anu, Ancient and Modern. It is an easy to read book, may appear light, but it is extremely heavy.
Blessed love, blessed, give thanks, salam to each and everyone. Welcome, Honorable Priest Isaac here with you. I am thankful that you could come and sup with us right here in the Tiger's Nest. I wanted to speak about something that I consider to be very important. In reality, the reason I initially was doing this video is to speak about the hike for our upcoming event, the Green Castle Hill Experience, Winter Solstice Experience 2018, from the 18th day, Tuesday the 18th day of December, until the 24th day of December 2018. And as I said, that is the 7-day cycle where we will be definitely highlighting our hike, our morning hike and our evening hike, the hike of the 21st and the hike of the 23rd, Friday and the Sunday, to directly communicate with the winter solstice and the sun in the southern hemisphere of the heavens, to its most southern point, to its 23 and a half degrees southern point, and then from that time on start to go northwards. So that is the whole science, really, as it relates to the solstice, the winter solstice. You have, of course, the summer solstice on the 21st day of June, and the equinoxes in March and September on the very same dates, the 20 and 1st. So I'm obviously inviting everyone again internationally, wherever you may be, whether you may be in Africa, any part, Ghana, Ivory Coast, our brothers in Ethiopia, South Africa, wherever you may be, it would be a joy that we could link up and go and experience the spirit of Greencastle Hill, the energy thereof, the megaliths, countless of megaliths that are aligned with the movements of the heavens, and those in Europe and those in the United States, North America, Canada, South America, Colombia, Brazil, Belize, all our brothers and sisters in Peru, wherever you may be, right here in the Caribbean, just across the waters, I can see you, Montserrat, my brothers and sisters in St. Kitts, St. Martin, Guadeloupe, and Dominique, and St. Lucia, and Barbados, and Grenada, and St. Vincent, but it's still a little distance, but they're still there, it ain't too far, and Trinidad, you know, where are you? Come down or come up, anywhere you want to call it, Jamaica, come cross. And let us, you know, experience Greencastle Hill. It would be obviously a joy for me to meet and greet with you. And you will be meeting and greeting with our community via the media, television, radio, and obviously with our events, the banquet and the hike, especially the hike of the afternoon hike, which is intended to be a big and grand event, while the morning hike will be a solemn event, you know. Both of them will be solemn to some degree. The sun, the sea, and the sand, and the beaches. Some people have been asking me directly about the beaches specifically more than anything else. Say, yeah, I want to come and dip in the beach. It's going to be cold up here. Well, I'm looking forward to you all. I'm looking forward to the experience, you know. I'm looking forward to the love and the joy. All you have to do, again, is to contact me. Email me, priestisaac@27@gmail.com. And I will give you, of course, the information that you need, which is the itinerary, the events, exactly what will be taking place. Remember, you'll be also meeting our griots, our historians, our activists, the authorities, and of course, you yourself will be put in a position, once you're not shy, to let the people know why you're here and the experience you expect. And even after the experience, there will be another chance for us to speak to the people so they understand. Because you will see the destruction that is taking place on Greencastle Hill. There is a serious destruction taking place on the hill. And you see, it's only when you experience the beauty of it, and then you see the destruction that follows, that you can really understand, wow, this is something taking place here. So I'm looking forward to entertaining you and accommodating you and just showing you the love that we have here for you in the nest of the tiger. But what I want to speak of, the reason why I entitled this little clip that I want to do is, you know, be careful who you worship. Now, the be careful who you worship, it's a bit out of the realms of just what we call worship and the characters that we choose to worship, whether it be the Allah and the Jesus, Buddhas, whatever it is that we say we worship. And that's at one realm, the Elohim, Kadamawe Haile Selassie. The realm that we say we choose to worship and pray and all of that. Okay, that's one thing. To be honest, you gotta be careful who you worship. But I don't mean on that level. I mean on another level brought into that level. And that is the whole aspect of personality worship. Now, the reason why I can speak of that, because it is something that I'm speaking of from my perspective. Now, over the years, I've been doing this mystic vibration. I don't mean the YouTube. When I say over the years, well, in my, at least in comparison to my age, is a long time, because it's a long time. 20 years to me is plenty time in comparison to my age. Someone else, another elder, may say, oh, that's just yesterday. Well, it was just yesterday. But in comparison to the rest of my time, that's plenty time so far. So We've been doing the mystic vibration in the same way for a while, man. Believe me, just take it from me. As you know, started on the radio, ZDK Radio, Zadok Radio, ZDK. Well, that's not what, it's not called Zadok, but I call it Zadok because ZDK is an acronym as such, well, if you want to call it that, of Zadok. But anyway, so we started on ZDK with the mystic vibration. You know, and we just took it from there, and all that you know of and have heard of and seen, and lectures and international lectures in many different universities and colleges, so many different radio programs, different places on the earth we have traveled and given lectures and all these things, and documentaries and videos and all the little things. But I'm just saying, so, and it has always been the mystic vibration. You know, you always hear me talk about people staying in their lane. So when you stay in your lane, a historian is a historian in the lane. You know, they have people that are researchers and are not teachers. They can do some good research and they have it, but if you have to not even debate, just to have a conversation back and forth, they may sound as if they don't even know what they're saying. Lane. That's why teamwork is key. Researcher, speaker. They have people that can speak, but they speak in all kind of weird things, and they catch plenty of people with the speech. And what they really have doesn't have the essence in it, but because the speech is 100% an A plus. Oh yeah, man, this is fireworks. Speaking of fireworks, let me just check my fire. You have a fire going here. It's, you know, you light a fire and keep a spirit. So what I'm saying is that staying in your lane is a key thing. So I always say that this is me. Yeah. So who you see here is who I am. I mean, obviously, looking at a person on a screen, no matter how many documentaries and videos you watch, that you cannot really know the person through that. But I'm just saying to you that what you see portrayed ain't no acting, nothing spouse up, nothing extra. Anybody that know me can tell you the same thing. This is just me. This is the me you know. All right. Now, I'm just saying this in the fullness to say, the mystic vibration is something that I consider lives with me. Yeah, the mystic vibration lives with me. It's not just a radio program or a television program. It has been, it's a reality programmed into me. Sometimes so many things are unraveled at one time, and you just got to keep it to yourself. So when you hear me come and say, some people say you're too boast with that, but I don't know what's so boast about saying that I know who I am. And when I say I know who I am, I don't mean like, you know what I mean, I know who I am, I am, I'm a child of God and them kind of things. No. I mean, I know who I am. So you hear people talking about, we were here before in another lifetime. We may not know who we were. And you're in the circle and you just gotta humble as if, well, we may not know. They may not know. But I can tell you clearly who I am. I'm telling you straight, whether you like it or not, I know who I am. And I don't mean like a person or something like that. I can give you good understanding of what's going on here. Good understanding. So let me show you what I mean. So when you watch the Master of Ceremonies and you watch Seven, the Night of the Black Tiger, whatever, and things are broken down in the same way that these things are broken down concerning the High Majesty and Marcus Messiah and other individuals, is the same way that I can break it down about myself. It's just not in book form, and I've never made a documentary about it. but I know exactly who I am, exactly to the point that if I was to do something on it, you yourself will say, wow, I can't believe it. This is some serious stuff. Obviously, I already showed you how I knew exactly which star was my star. Well, for the YouTube people, you may not have heard that because that was from our Shock of the Hour program. But all Shock of the Hour listeners and subscribers for sure would have heard the program that we did, How Do You Know Who You Are? And I told you which star is exactly my star, because we all would say, oh, we all have a star, but that is true. Of course you have a star. What are you talking about? So which star is your star? Well, we don't really know. Okay, now I know exactly which star is my star. And when I explained, you know, how I know which star is my star, it's just like, okay, without a doubt. And for those that don't, you know, you see, the thing is, that is why it's good that you subscribe, you know. You see YouTube taking out videos, and so when they don't like what you say, soon they look into banned channels. We have a subscription, you know, wherein we bring forward the Shock of the Hour program daily. Definitely everything 1/3, even less, doesn't come on the YouTube. So I'm telling you, there's a lot of information for those who are really serious about information. But anyway, the point I'm making is that what I'm going to say now is really a part of a bigger story, which I can't tell now. And that is why you really appreciate it when you hear the full story. But let me just give you the little still. I'm saying that there was a specific time where there was this conversation concerning the same aspect of stars. And if a person have a star, and if you know which star is your star and all of that. And within communication, my brothers and sisters, with the Most High, I literally requested to know my star. And it was within days. I got a rash right on my left ankle to the outer part. And I kid you not, because there were people that I showed the rash. Imagine I showing somebody rash. The rash, it was some little red dots. I honestly can't recall ever getting a rash, at least in my older age then. This was about, it's a while ago though. It was about about a decade plus, you know, as Rastafari. So the rash was in the formation of the Orion constellation. As I said, I showed people the rash. Say, hey, watch this, what I look like. And I didn't have to explain. And the mystic is that, you know, obviously at that time we were talking about Orion and the movements of the heavens and all of that. And it was like, wait, the shield, the sword, everything. And the position, how Orion stays, right on my left ankle there. And I came to the conclusion. Now remember, I was asking to know which star I am in. Now, you may say, wow. So what you're trying to tell me, you're the whole Orion? You are Orion? Well, hold on. I asked for a star. Now, the fact that the Orion constellation appeared in a rash, as a rash, on my left ankle here, I took it upon myself to assume that the star that represents the left foot of Orion, which is, some call it Rigel, I say Rigel, is my star. And the fact that I was communicating with the beyond with a specific request, and that came like within, It wasn't within no time. Surely it wasn't a week. And knowing we were studying the constellations heavily at that time too. I'm just saying that I consider that Rigel or Rigel is my star. Now, that little thing, I just showed you that was just a piece in a long story that I was given on the radio program. But the point I'm making is, that's just natural. If that was 10 years ago or more, there are so many things that have happened within that time. It's a daily thing. I'm trying to make a point. I'm trying to make a serious point. That the mystics are open to us all the time. It's no once a year or special nothing. It's speaking now. Even as I'm speaking to you, the mystics are being revealed. The heavens declare the glory alone. Clouds speak to you. So I'm saying that I accept that. I mean, in the earlies, you know, you tend to look down. It's like Moses and the burning bush. So I said, no, I'm going to look away. And when I look back, this bush is not going to be on fire and everything is going to be all right, because Moses couldn't understand what he's looking at there. And even when the father say, hey, it's me, man, cool out, this is what you got to do. No. It can't be me, man. You got to be kidding. So, you know, for a time, we would work with that spirit. That kind of spirit, like, oh, it's too heavy. And I'm telling you, daily, it's nonstop. The communication that I personally know that I have with the astral world. I'm positive. If I ain't positive by now, I nuts. I positive. So I'm just showing you that to show you that I have full confidence in myself. I know who I am. And I try my utmost best to what we call live up. Now, in saying all of that now, the reason why I said that this subject area is coming from my perspective is because I got a problem with the personality worship kind of thing. And over the years, I mean, people have, you know, come and told me all sorts of different things, you know. People call me Messiah. People open the Bible and say, this angel here is one of the trumpet blowers. This one is you. Some people say, you're Emmanuel, come again. Some people say, boy, you have to be this and that and all sorts of things. Believe me, I've received it. And I come to realize, now we're going to be, as they say, 100 here. I come to realize that young people and young, what you call women, I would prefer to say young princesses and empresses, especially when they believe in you, they are extremely vulnerable. Young people, when I say young people, anything coming up in their high teens and their 20s, and they believe in you, very vulnerable. And I know for sure, I am positive that they are people out there that are very charismatic and may have what they call the gift of gab and can say the right words. As I said at the beginning of this, they have people that may not have the exact knowledge, truth, information, but just the way they kick it, the way they move, the way they dress, they can move the crowd and they can steal some hearts. And it's the reality. I remember one day a brethren of mine was trying to tell me that I am holy and he's not holy. So I asked him, how did he come, you know, to that conclusion that I am holy? And it took a while to give me an answer. He said, what do you mean, man, priest? I mean, come on, you don't know. I said, no, I don't know how you know I am holy. He said, man, look how you dress. That's exactly what he said. I said, how I dress? Come on, man, that can't be it. How I dress? Rasta, I know enough people that dress like this. And I'm not judge number one, but I'm positive that they ain't holy. But I'm just saying, especially to the young ones, you gotta be very careful. When you mature, you tend to change your outlook on different things in life. It's just like when you were a preteen and when you were 7 and 6 years old. You had a specific outlook. You were concerned with certain things and not concerned with other things. But as you mature, you change. So now that you may be in your 20s, early 20s, or wherever you may be, I'm telling you, when you get in your 30s, and for sure when you hit your 40s, things may look a bit different than it looks now. So you gotta reserve certain meditation with understanding. So I'm saying you have to be careful. Especially when it comes to certain spiritual things. Now, I personally, I am a priest of the Ethiopia Africa Black International Congress Church of Salvation. That's why I am. I'm not the priest. I am a priest. People who call me high priest, Christ is the high priest. I'm speaking of the Melchizedek. Now I know we're going to go all over the world with this and say, well, yeah, man, but Christ in all of us. Okay, I understand that. I mean, isn't it that what I speak of? Christ is in all of us. Exactly. You know, there you go. So if Christ is in all of us, ain't no need for you to pick out one Christ more than anybody else. You know, well, then you can just look in the mirror and deal with the vibes, because you're the Christ. But it's obvious, my brothers and sisters, that amongst all of us, the Christ and the God, God in all of us too, isn't it? Yeah, God is in all of us. Am I correct? God is in all of us. Good. But it's obvious that amongst all of us, the gods, there are those down to the point that there is also even he and she that come with a certain level of this God stuff. There are those that come with this Christhood thing, like perfected. You understand? That's the level I'm talking about. And that is why we see them as Christ one time, because they have it perfected. You know, most of us, we ain't got it perfected. In fact, we are very far. We need extra lessons. It's in us, but we're not fully there. So even if the message is good, and I am not dampering no one spirit at all as it relates to me, because again, I know exactly who I am. You know, the angel blowing the trumpet and all these things, I mean, these are good guests, you know, but I'm just trying to show you, be careful with the personality worship. So yeah, be very, very careful. That can break your heart and break your soul. Very, very important. And even if it's not the worship as such, even expectations, because I ain't perfect. I don't know who is, but I ain't there yet. And I would use the term yet, because I'm working on it. No, I can be very clear with you. Again, as I said at the beginning of this video, I am who I am. So who you see talking to you here, what you hear me talk about, what I say I don't believe in and deal with, you ain't gonna find me dealing with it on the side. So I can tell you, like just tell you that that's me. You know, so I try my utmost best to live up to even what you hear me say. and there's much more to say. But I know I ain't perfect though. You know? And praises and so, it's good to give praises where it's due, I hear you. But there are few people that have come to me over the years and even in recent times. And I've sat with them one on one, I mean, even if it's through the internet, and I've spoken to them clearly with certain understanding. Because if you're going to tell me I'm Emmanuel returning, you know, well, you got to prove that to me. I ain't just going to take that and walk with that, prove it. Yeah, I'm telling you the truth. There are people that contact me and tell me I am the Christ. I'm the Christ of this time. So, go on WhatsApp or with this email and I say, prove it. And they can't prove it. They cannot prove it. It cannot be proven by them. They feel it because they see something that they think this, you know, I mean, come on. So, I mean, this is Priest Isaac, you know. Priest Isaac. So the priest alone carry to a next level. The name alone, if you're not stable in yourself, the name alone carry far. Isaac, biblical character. That alone can move you. That alone can move you. Well, that's my name. Well, priest isn't my name, but my name is Isaac. Priest is my title. I am a priest of the Ethiopia Africa Black International Congress. I refer to myself as that, not only that, as Honorable Priest Isaac. It don't mean like if I think I'm better than nobody else. You should see yourself as Honorable, whatever your name is. That's how we see it. That's how Marcus Garvey taught us to honor ourselves. In fact, I always show you that it is Priest Donovan. Priest Donovan, when I went to Bobby Hill for the first time, and he was asking me, what's the name? And at that time, it was Prophet Kidemi. And I told him that my name is Kidemi. And he said, no, my Lord, there must honor yourself, my Lord. It's Honorable Prophet Kidemi. And I never stopped saying honorable since then. You know, and when I took on the priesthood, I decided to use my surname, which is Isaac. Honorable Priest Isaac. But I'm just showing you the name alone can flip you and carry you far. Like, wow, this priest, this is this great priest. And I'm a priest, one priest. Within an order of priests. You just don't see them on YouTube or maybe hearing them on the radio, but I mean, but they're on YouTube too, but I mean, concentrated like how you see your brother concentrated here, you know, talking to you. If thanks to the Holy Rock coming over the horizon, you know. But I'm just showing you that I am a priest of such an order. And honorable because Marcus Garvey told us to honor ourselves. So you should honor yourself as well. That's what I'm saying. So I know that I am a teacher within this time. I mean, it'll be just foolish of me to think, nah, man, I ain't no teacher. That's dumb. You're a teacher, Priest Isaac. Come on, stop the foolishness. Stop pretending. You are a teacher. But I never got no word that I'm the Christ. You know, I would love to attain to the Christhood. I wouldn't mind at all. In fact, I'm trying my best. But I know, my brothers and sisters, please. Young ones, especially. Because the wider audience may not understand it. Even speaking this to you is as if a feeling coming through me, man. The wider audience may not understand. But it is natural to see people and gravitate to them. We all, some of us, we have been inspired by people and we cut them off. When I say cut them off, I don't mean out of our life like we don't call them anymore. I mean cut them off from your whole psyche, you know? Michael Jordan has touched many of us. Michael Jackson has touched many of us. These are people that have touched me. Whatever other issues you may have with these people, they definitely are spiritual beings. Michael Jordan, people say he's the best basketball player. He's the best. Straight up. He's a better ball player than Tiger Woods is a golfer, than Mike Tyson is a boxer or any one of them. I don't think you ever really watch what Michael Jordan really did on that basketball court. You know, that was something else. That's different. You know? That's beyond the game of basketball, I'm telling you. And I'm not speaking from reruns. I mean, speaking from following it as it was taking place. Michael Jackson, a different thing altogether, you know. Within my scope itself, I was touched a lot by the whole vibration within the frequency of Rakim as well. So I'm just showing you that we all, and that's at a young age too, we all have it within ourselves to seek for a role model. So if you're seeking for spiritual things, and especially if you've already realized that Rastafari is the thing, you know, and then on here comes this robed and turbaned brother, and this is how I dress. This is how I dress. You come and knock on my door and open, this is what I have on. I don't put it on to come on the camera. So this is me. So you see this robe and turban brother and burning chalice like some elder, some guru somewhere. And every time the man talk, the man just twist the thing up, brother. Boy, the man can bring down the stars, brother. Listen, the man come in the next thing again, you know. Yeah, boy, you know, hear when the man talk about this thing. Look, the man show video, right? And the man show the Pope. Hey, this man, hey, this, I don't know, regular man. I agree. I totally agree, you know. I ain't no regular man. I am not no regular man. But what about you? Are you a regular man? Are you a regular woman? More than likely not. We are all superhuman beings, brother. You know? I'm going to repeat again. I know my place. And as far as the instructions that I've been given, my place is not the place to be worshipped, nor to be idolized, or none of them extreme stuff. I am just your brother. Take it from me. You know, I give thanks. I appreciate, you know, the esteem level that you would like to carry me, you know, and I intend to get there someday, but I could tell you in the open public, I ain't there yet. Believe me. And the teachings of the Christ is to teach other people to be Christ. That is why Prince Emmanuel is our Christ. He brings us closer to Christ as the Melchizedek. He brings us closest to Christ, even if it's just the dressing too. Because the dressing is a part of the Christhood, really. So the brethren was correct with the dressing, you know. But dressing don't make you holy. The dressing don't make you Christ. Trust me. The heart is what make you the Christ. Yeah. So give thanks, my brothers and sisters. As I said, I'm your brother, man. And I said, many of you listening, you may not understand why I had to say this. But trust me, I know why I had to say it. You know, I'm not going to expose nobody. But I'm telling you, because of what I've said, and maybe how it's been said, and whatever else you may see when you look at me, you may be surprised. I don't even want to say this in a kind of way, you know. Wow, you ever heard me hold such a long gap as if I can't find the words to say? Yeah. It's as if I have to say it because it doesn't come in a kind of way, you know. Sometimes the reason why we hesitate to even come, you know, on camera too often, and sometimes just leave the pictures and maybe, well, at least sometimes, as you could see, you're listening to some of our programs from the Shock of the Hour too. And people get caught up in what they see. Let's just put it that way. People get caught up a lot in what they see. And visual is very important too, obviously. As I said, nothing wrong in seeing someone that you'd like to emulate, someone that you have confidence in, someone that you'd like to be like then, if you want to put it that way. I mean, nothing wrong with that. I ain't telling nobody not to want to be like me. Yeah, I'm not saying I'm not a good role model. Hey, I'm not a thief, you know. I don't thief. I don't or steal. I don't lie. I don't abuse people. Nothing. I don't take advantage of nobody. I really try my utmost best to be righteous and holy for real, you know, man. Yeah. But yeah, as I said, it's good to want to be like. But I'm telling you, a lot of people, they're just attracted to what they see, you know, the colors and whatever they see, whatever it is they see, both male and female. Yeah. And there is a time when it is the message, not the messenger. The message, not the messenger. So I'm encouraging all young ones. Eh? Don't get caught up in a personal personality worship. You could lose yourself there, you know? People get caught up in personality worship and lose their whole bank account. You understand? People don't know. I see people comment and say some dumb things about me and some things that I mean. That boy, anyway, so it is, you know. But I have people I refuse things from. I tell you, I ain't no donation box, you know. I have services and I have products. And I feel quite content dealing with my products and my services. I don't really refuse anyone who wants to contribute something towards what I do. It really comes in good. I really give thanks. The essay competition that went last time, I'm very thankful to the international community who really came forward and assisted. But as far as and anyone that says they want to donate something, I really take it. I'm not telling you, but there are people that I've not taken things from. And when I look back, I said, I'm glad I never take that. There are even people that I've taken things from that I said I should have never taken nothing from them people there. You know, backstabbers and other sort of kind of different vibration. So this is what I'm telling you. You yourself got to be careful. Because as a young soul, when you get caught up, especially when you're seeking God, and you think you find the man, because from a person find somebody that they think is the chief servant of God, you know, they believe that, well, everything that they have belongs to this chief servant of God or chief servant of whatever, and you could give away your whole life savings to this chief servant of God. And it has happened. We even see it played out on the internet, even like a day like today. I ain't accusing nobody. I don't know. I haven't seen the results from the trial. But that's what's going around in the internet. This person scammed that person. And somebody gave away his inheritance to somebody else because he thought that he had a good program going on and them kind of things. You know. Now, obviously, the kind of cash I hear, a fella give somebody else, you would only give away them kind of money there if you feel it's Jesus or one of them fellas come down walking on the planet, you know. And even if it's not in a religious sense, but in a life saving soul saving sense, really, let's put it that way. Because I mean, child, you understand. So I'm showing you, my brothers and sisters, take the knowledge, take the information. Give thanks for the love and the praises. I'm telling you, this is your brother, and I don't want to go on like I'm pure or too pure. My mother always said, you know, if it's one thing with you, you're very innocent. That's my mother. She always tell me that. If it's one thing with you, you're very innocent. So give thanks for my mother for saying that, and I'm telling you straight. Having faith in me in a sense, then, like, I mean, don't be having faith in me. Have faith in yourself, you know. But I'm telling you, the confidence then that you put in me, it's not going to be wasted. Because I, as I said, try my best on my part to do what is right. And what I do, whatever you see me do and say, is pure and is coming from the depths of my soul. Yeah, so you don't have to worry about that. But the personality worship part, please, leave me out of it. It's not for me. Trust me. I know who I am. But ain't nobody to come and kneel down to me and come and bow and kissing my foot and all that kind of thing. I mean, if people do all of that, you don't even know. Yeah, it's not necessary. I give thanks. I see how you feel. Love, love. You wash my feet, I wash your feet too. You understand? That's how the Father teaches. So give thanks, Black Christ. So yeah, what are we talking about? The hike, December, from the 18th to the 24th day. We're gonna drop the ad so you could see exactly what we're talking about. All you have to do is contact me and everything is blessed. Yeah, so it's a wonderful morning, the sun coming up, a few little flies around, you know, that's why we have to light our little fire there and keep it going. Yeah, give thanks to the life given, the keeper of life, Kelemawi, Haile Selassie I. You know, all good doings and saying, this went a little longer than I expected, but I just wanted the, you know, at least the message to be clear and the words out to be understood at this time, especially to the young hearts and the young souls. It's very easy to get led astray, especially when something looks nice and colorful. I don't want to be responsible for that at all. In fact, I don't want to be. I can't be responsible for them kind of things. I would never encourage nothing like that. As I tell you, anybody that come to me with them extra talk, especially if they seem serious, I mean, you don't know, some serious people come demand and say, hey, maybe you don't know, brother. Maybe you don't know. No, you don't even know. Maybe you don't know, brother, but I see it already. I see it. I was watching the video, there was this light behind your head. Okay, I ain't doubting that. I ain't saying that. I mean, these things can happen. Of course, I mean, that could, maybe he can, maybe he's the one that can see the light. See? So that more may have given him, maybe he's the one with the power to be able to see the light, because we all got a light in us, some dimmer than some. But he just happened to see my light. Maybe he has the ability to see my light. Maybe I need him to tell me the color of my light. Yeah. How about that? Because this brother's, yeah, man, I'm telling you. And so I said, okay, differently than the light. Prove to me that I'm who you say I am. Yeah, got a man swear that I'm the Christ, you know. Manuel, come again, prove it. Some little Bible and some revelation thing, and this angel sounded, and when the seven angels sound, the mystery of God shall be known. Mystically, that's a phrase I used to use a long time ago. When the seven angels sound, that's in Revelation, the mystery of God shall be known. I swear, man, brother, that is you. Okay. Alright, you know. I always thought that was Prince Emmanuel, specifically. I mean, I understand when you say, I mean, it's true time, you know, because even if you think I'm someone else, but I'm still me, and that someone else is still that someone else, whether we carry the same spirit or not. And I always said that's King Emmanuel, the seventh. That's his name, you know, King Emmanuel, the seventh. And when he soundeth, the mystery of God shall be known, because you see, as simple as he may seem to have taught it, that was the mystery of God. And you know, even though I may come and all of this and all of that, look at the video we did on 33. Did you watch the video on 33? And I showed you how even within the black supremacy, you know, because other people come and say, boy, it's different ones come and type up that book and so on. So what that all mean then? Is the spirit of the Almighty working through, and the 33 highlighting the book, you know, that's the same powers of the same King Emmanuel, as simple as he may have came and fulfilled. So I see that he is the seventh angel that blow the trumpet and the mystery revealed. That's just it. Again, I ain't putting myself down, because I know where I fit in. Don't worry, man, check yourself with the personality worship. You know, as I always say, if you know your Bible and you do not know your dictionary, I was going to say a while ago, you know, if you know your Bible and you do not know your dictionary, if you know your Bible and you do not know your history, the knowledge of your Bible will become a mystery. And you know, it takes some real eyes to realize the real lies that are amongst us, Black Christ in flesh, Holy Emmanuel I, Selassie, Jah, Rastafari. Yeah, man, I sent the sun. Have a blessed day. Black over white, Theta morning. Going into the Sabbath day. The Sabbath order of the Black Christ. King Emmanuel Charles Edwards, worthy to be praised. Exodus 20 and Exodus 31. Man said that the Sabbath day, keep the Sabbath day, definitely will keep life. And it's a day that you put all tools aside, all knife and all mattock and all fork and even the line that you hang your clothes on, you drop the line even on the Sabbath day, you know, for all preparation. By right according to even the constitution, all baking supposed to seal since midday. You know, in ancient time, man would be baking even from the Thursday night. Food preparation, and then you start to prepare for the Sabbath itself coming in at 6. Even in the ancient time, and you know, at 5:30, all ones should be gathered by the tabernacle in their whites, ready for the Psalms reading and going into the sabbatical service. So give thanks to that day, the Sabbath, day of rest, a day of tranquility, a day of joy, not a day of sleep, because it's a rest, but it's a day when you rest on all the tools of work, even if it's not Babylon work, it could be your own work, you still rest on them tools there, still, and put certain things aside and concentrate on praising, you know, and clapping and singing and reading of your Bible and hymn book and all other books of high quality. At that time, you more keep to the holy scriptures, you know, and that's the Sabbath day, the day of rest. You know, your food have been prepared from since the day before. And congregation break the fast at 12 and go into the feasting and rejoice and glorify, because it's a connection with the earth again, a renewal once again into a new strong, a new cycle of life. So we're thankful for that day of rest, the Sabbath day, the ever living day of salvation, you know, because it's an ever living day. That's why you hear about the eternal Sabbath. That's why you hear about the 7-year Sabbath. That's why even Isaiah speak about from new moon to new moon and from Sabbath to Sabbath, they shall still come and assemble before the Most High. And that's in the time to come, you know. So for when one say that the Sabbath has passed, this is not Bible alone, you know. This is not religion and this is not Christianity. This is science itself. This is the metaphysics of the Sabbath. This is the balancing of the yin and yang, as we were taught by Dr. Lila Africa. We understand that it's on this day that they call Saturday, named from Saturn. We understand all of that, but this is not about the name. This is about the frequency of the moment, of the movements of the ether and the sun and the moon and everything else. And that day, the portals open on a different level in comparison to even the days prior to it or before it or after it, the Sabbath day, the seventh day. So give thanks to Abba Sabbath, Abba Sabbath, Abba Sabbath. You know, this is the man that Negus and Agas refer to as the Lord of the Sabbath 3 times, from even when he visited on the special visit in 1970. You know, that is 1970. That was on a Thursday. That was according to the Black Christ himself on a Thursday in January 1970. The King of Kings also paid him a special visit and referred to him as Abba Sabbath, Abba Sabbath, Abba Sabbath. You know, the father of the Sabbath. So we're thankful again for that Melchizedek, the ancient one that come and lay the foundation and open up all doors. King Emmanuel VII, Adonai, my God, Jah, Rastafari, my Lord, sanctify us. My Lord and Empress.
Give thanks and praise for life, and Selassie is alive. Yaman, the land of the priests.
Green Castle Hill, the Stonehenge of the Caribbean.
2018 Winter Solstice Experience. Join us in Sun City, Antigua, from Tuesday the 18th to Monday the 24th day of December. Come and bask in the mystic of the Stonehenge of the Caribbean. Come and experience sun, sea, sand, and legend. Spend 7 days and nights in the heart of the Caribbean. Visit our national heritage sites. Meet and greet our people. Sample the local fruits and produce. Plus, the beach, banquets, lectures, yoga, and of course, Green Castle Hill. Green Castle Hill, Mount Anu.
Save our national treasure.
Oh, blessed love family, do give thanks. Just one question. How are your kicks? Huh? How are your shoes? What are you wearing? We are now offering the best in leather footwear, emanating out of the factory of Top Ranking Limited, right here in Antigua, in St. John's, in the nation of Antigua and Barbuda. Brother Nathaniel Maynard, also known as Top Ranking, and his wonderful family have established an enterprise that has stood the test of time.
But it's so different today. And because of what transpired and that early gift, but now it's Top Ranking, you now decide that you want to give back to the young people of Antigua and Barbuda. Tell me about that.
Yes, this skill that I possess is very deep, and it's not common. I think we've created a phenomenal thing, and I need to have it continued. So I'm investing in the youth of the island, mm-hmm. to teach them, no cost to teaching them whatever they want to know about the skill, whatever department. But there are different procedures and different for different items, and we have all the techniques of doing it. So I want to give on to the youths that
you
went anybody who's interested.
You went off to Italy at a later stage.
Yes, I did, after 12 years of experience.
That trip was for to upgrade.
To upgrade, yeah, to learn the industrial system of production.
And now, let me see those things.
With this new line of footwear, we are offering boots, ladies' shoes, ladies' sandals, slippers, work shoes, dress shoes, whatever it is, name it, as it relates to footwear, and it is produced in the factory of Top Ranking. You could order your shoes on wholesale as well as retail. See anything that you like? Just contact me. Area code 12687283162, or email me priestisaac27@gmail.com, and I could give you an example of what all we have in store as well as the price list. And remember that the quality of the footwear has definitely been tried, tested, and has been proven to be of upstanding. Blessed love.
Learn a trade and work for yourself. Yeah, you've done it. You guys have done it. Yeah, and successfully you have.
Subscribe to the Mystic Vibrations Shock of the Hour program today and never miss another episode. The Shock of the Hour is a Radio Anu exclusive program produced every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. By now, I am sure that you are aware that all our programs are packed with information, inspiration, mystic vibrations, as well as hot button topics. Every evening we enter into a different dimension, even if it is a part two of the previous program, whether it's history or mystery, biology or philosophy, domestic affairs or the locks of your hair. The Mystic Vibration is sure to bring something new and interesting to the table every evening. So never miss another episode again. Subscribe to the Shock of the Hour now. And don't forget your key Swahili word of the day and your daily scientific fact. So, to subscribe, give us an email, priestisaac27@gmail.com, or call or WhatsApp us today. Area code 12687283162. The Shock of the Hour. Never miss another program. And a special note to all our new subscribers. All our new subscribers will receive a special copy of the DVD documentary, Full Length, The Night of the Black Tiger, The Divinity of Marcus Messiah Black.